Hi there, I'm Manish Sinha, the CMO at STL, Starlight Technologies, and today we're going to talk about something that all of us know a little bit about and most of us want to know a lot more about. What is it? Edge compute. Well, I'm sure you've heard the term. And if you're watching this video on LinkedIn or Twitter or anytime when you watch videos on Netflix or Amazon Prime or whatever is your favorite streaming service, you know you're getting it from something, from a server that's not too far away. They are sending the stuff close to you. They're sending the things that you need for your internet experience close to the edge. That's the basic understanding. But how about we try to dive into it a little bit more? Today we have with us Sandeep Dhingra, who has been a technologist with IBM and Cisco, and now he is the Chief Technology Officer at the Network Services and Software Business at STL. Welcome, Sandeep.
Thank you, Manish. Glad to be here, and I believe you have described the edge pretty well.
So one of the things that I actually want to start with, Sandeep, you know, why should we care about edge computing?
Very good question, right? And especially during the time when, you know, there's a lot of hype around it. So I'll say three things. Number one, it is a major generational architecture shift, right? The second, it is essential for the key revolution that is going on in digital infrastructure called Internet of Things. It is not IoT, but there are a huge number of use cases which will be enabled by edge compute. So for these three things, it is very important. So let me talk about it. What do I mean by architectural shift? If you look at in 1960s, we had this big mainframes, right? We have all the terminals we connect. So that is the standard centralized model, right? And then in 80s, kind of everything was upside down. And we moved to a client server model and the AS400s and, you know, Oracle servers, these were the type of things that were kinks. And then in 2000, and again, we took a turn and we started cloud computing. Now, cloud computing, which, you know, it was a large scale model, you know, shared infrastructure across this thing, but it is centralized. Now, you have seen how it has revolutionized IT and technology in itself. But now we realize when the IoT came, we realized that, you know, everything cannot be and must not be run in the cloud, that is centralized model. So then what did we do? In edge computing, cloud moves to the edge. The computing moves to the edge. But now it completes the circle. Now if you look at IDC, you know, they have displayed it very nicely. It is really a generational shift that is completing the full technology cycle from centralized to distributed compiled. So that is about the architecture shift. Now, there are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 billions of devices are going to be connected in future. But the point is, a huge amount of data will not only be created at the edge, but it will be processed, needed to be computed and processed at the edge. And by some estimates, we're talking about 45 to 50% of overall data that needs to be processed at the edge. So that is what is changing. That is why we should care.
That's very, very interesting. And thanks for taking us through the journey. But two things that really popped out to me is that this whole thing of edge computing has been here for nearly two decades. And also that very soon it will take over 40 to 50% of the things that we are computing on the internet. That's amazing. But one thing that I would love to know from you is, what exactly is edge computing?
You're right. So there's a lot of confusion about edge, right? So first thing that you need to realize that the users, the devices like cell phones, your laptops, your sensors, your robotic arms, your army tanks potentially, these things connect. That is the physical location is called edge. Now, if you talk about edge computing is nothing but computing happening on the edge. That basically a topology element. So compute can happen at the cloud, at the data center. In this case, we are talking about is happening at the edge. Now, cloud computing is really a style of computing that basically provides you shared infrastructure, the resource elasticity, you can up and down, you can provide platform, it provides like horizontal scale, it provides your catalog, pay-as-you-go model. So these are, this is the style of computing. When you eat this style of computing to edge of the network, you can call it edge cloud or cloud network.
Thanks for telling us a little bit about what exactly it is. And I think the differentiation between edge and computing on the edge and the cloud, all of that really helps. If you can help us understand, why is edge compute so disruptive? What is it fundamentally changing?
Let's say, like, what does edge computing do, right? Let's say if you do this amount of compute power at the edge of the network where things are connecting. So it does provide three things. Number one, it provides a very low latency that enables lots of applications that wouldn't have been possible otherwise. Then it ensures when you have huge amount of data that is being generated, that does not need to be sent back to the cloud or data center. Third, it helps keep the data local. If there was no compute at the edge and computation was necessary to make decisions, then the data would have to be inevitably sent to a data center or a cloud. But with edge compute, with local processing, we can keep the data local. Now, these three things are enabled by the edge that basically makes it possible for thousands of net new applications to be run and new use cases spawn that and new efficiencies and productivity in hundreds of different verticals and sectors. That is why it is disruptive.
That's very interesting. Thousands of new applications running. But you actually mentioned something that probably is a very simple word in the way technologists understand, but I wanted to understand it in a more simpler way, which is latency. What does really latency mean? And, you know, what are some of the reasons and why do we care too much about it?
And really, literally, it means time it takes for, information or packet from point A to point B, right? So typically it is in tens of milliseconds. So, but what is happening with IoT is there is a lot of machine-to-machine communication. So at machine scale, now machines, when we talk there, we're talking microseconds, right? Let's say if there is a gas pump in a refinery that is monitoring a pressure that needs to be shut quickly without human intervention. And, lots of these things can be adjusted. Now that requires ultra low latency, very, very low latency. The latency in human scale and human applications is different than in machine scale. In human scale, it is in tens of milliseconds. In machine scale, it is under 10, under 1, and sometimes in microseconds.
Anything else that you think is making it imperative for the edge compute to become important?
So, yes, there are other things. One is the sheer amount of data, right? When you have millions of sensors or you have, 8K streaming surveillance videos, that data, you don't want to send it because it is costly to send data. So just the bandwidth and data is another one, right? And then there are scenarios where, you need autonomy. That is, you need cloud, but you need to have most of the infrastructure still be able to run if there is no cloud. You basically use cloud only to send, let's say, data for further analysis, or you send for training your machine learning models. In the case of, let's say, a hospital or a military outpost where you still make everything needs to work properly, and then you have the privacy and security for data localization. So these are the key imperatives that make edge computing really important and critical.
On the other hand, Sandeep, we also know that edge computing ranges from a lot of different use cases, right? Maybe you talked about machine to machine. There's a wide range of things. I also hear that it's extremely important for edge computing to be at its best for things like connected cars and autonomous vehicles. What is happening there? Why is that important?
So there are two major. One, the edge doesn't have any impact, right? Whatever we are doing now, if I'm doing a web application, it's running without the edge, I'm fine. But some applications get enhanced with the edge that you touched in the beginning, right? But then applications that are really make use of edge in a super enhanced way. And that is where we talk about, like, say, high definition video surveillance and 4K, 8K video screens. But the real difference that comes where there are applications that cannot run without the edge, that are called edge native applications. There is no way they can run without the edge. And autonomous car, you mentioned, vehicles you mentioned, is one such example. One use case that is also very important is telco space. It's called multi-access edge computing.
Thank you so much for sharing all of this with us, Sandeep, and looking forward to meeting you at the edge.
Thank you, Manish. As I have to say, we are on the edge of a revolution. Thank you, Manish. Thanks for having me.
Thanks so much.